Hello guys, it's Broke Genius. Coming to you once again. This video is very, very important to me, at least. One of the biggest things on why I started to zero in on economic ideas and financial knowledge and gaining understanding about how the global financial market works and things of that nature is basically a date, a time that I'll never forget, and it's the 2008 housing collapse, or the quote unquote Great Recession. Backdrop for me, 2008. I wasn't really doing like great. I have to admit, during that time either. I was just pretty much living in an apartment, just getting by, working. I was just starting my career in IT, and I just living in an apartment, had a car, and just kind of average lifestyle, whatever. For someone in my age group at that time, it was like, everything was kind of somewhat normal, I would say, till about 2008. I started to notice, things just kind of unraveling for me, but that wasn't nothing new. The new thing was that things started to slowly unravel for a lot of people until like it pretty much the whole world unraveled, as it seemed. People just started losing their houses. Fortunately for me, I tried to get a mortgage. I was trying to get in real estate before then and, for the longest, but I wasn't able to get one. I'm thankful. I used to feel bad about not being able to get a loan, and I can't believe to say this, that I would ever say this, but I am so thankful that I did not get a loan, because it was just, unless you lived in a very selective neighborhood, the housing prices just plummeted. If you got a loan because of, basically supply and demand, simple economics, your house was basically worth less than what you owed on it. And that was for a majority of the people that had mortgages and had properties that they had a loan on. So the bank, you have to pay them back no matter what. They don't lose in that situation. You are the one that lose, the person that has that loan. So it was just, a lot of people I started to notice getting homeless, and people were, it's just a lot of doom and gloom. It was just, everybody was just kind of like, seemed like, just, I don't know, just in a state where they were not, used to, and high unemployment rates. And I remember I was, basically driving a cab, and I've never driven a cab before. It was a short experience. I only had to do it for like a month. A little more than a month, but more like a month and a half. Then I, kind of switched gears and went back to kind of jobs that I normally do. But yeah, it was a lot of people that were in that same boat, that were doing things they normally wouldn't do. One thing that shockingly that I won't forget is that, you would have to position yourself to kind of, you know, where I'm going with this is that a lot of people made money off of this disaster. And I mean, it was like a lot of doom and gloom. And I have to admit, I was with that crowd of doom and gloomers. And I mean, you would, if you would have even just put a little money in certain areas, you would have obviously now made a lot of money. And I was kind of in a doom and gloom crowd, so I didn't capitalize on it, nor did I even, I mean, before 2008, I wasn't really concerned that much about the economy. I wasn't concerned about personal finance, business finance. I wasn't concerned about these things. After the collapse, it became agenda number one for me, because, you know, I just was, took the stance that this, I have to be a lot wiser and smarter to deal with this if this ever happens again, and even just in general, because it's more serious than what, you know, what people portray it to be. And I think everybody should learn as much as they can about financing and the economy and anything business related, you know, because everybody has to deal with some type of business there, you know, whether it be their own personal business or, you know, their actual business as far as having their own, you know, sole proprietorship, corporation, LLC, stuff like that. So it's something everybody should, you know, have some type of business acumen. And it's like, basically, a lot of people made money. A lot of people were even waiting, because some people were alive, you know, or older enough to see this kind of happen, you know, in the 80s. I mean, I was just a child, but they were literally waiting for this to happen and seize the moment, opportunity to jump on it, because it was like, you know, they knew exactly how to position themselves, what to look for, and so on and so forth. Whereas a lot of people were taking their money and taking it out the stock market. They were, you know, instead of trying to get into real estate, they were trying to get more properties or whatever. They were just trying to, you know, settle out what they, you know, what they had to deal with as far as their own personal property, and kind of shut down the camp and start over again, type of thing. And it's like, that's what people were doing. I mean, instead of trying to, I mean, I remember going to look for properties with my mother, and it was just like, everything was very expensive. I mean, I didn't think they were that expensive. Well, I did think they were kind of expensive then, but I had no idea that, you know, they could possibly be as low as they are. I mean, certain properties that I used to look at in 2005, 2006, these properties are, I would say, they were like 100 grand on average, right? Those same properties, 2008 till 2010 and so on and forth, even today, they're like only a third of the price of what they were in 2005, 2006. So that same house that was probably 100 grand only be 30,000 now. I mean, granted, you would only have to pay, it'd be hard trying to get a mortgage on that and stuff like that. It's, you know, it's cash deals, but I mean, it's just mind-boggling. You would, if you got a mortgage in 2005 for 100 grand, you still paying for it. And you only getting, it's only a third percent of the value of what you're paying for. But I mean, I'm not, you know, I'm all for responsibility, but I mean, just think, like, if you spend that same 100 grand, you can get 3 houses today's, you know, with today's market, or even more. I mean, it's a lot of properties that were like, I mean, the one I'm sending you a video on pretty much was 90 grand. And is, and the person that the company that bought it, that I work through, or that I, you know, deal with, only paid 10% of that value of this same house that I'm in. So I mean, it's just, what I'm saying is that whole era, that whole time period, I learned, you know, possibly don't panic. Possibly, maybe, no, the United States is not going to crumble. You know, it's not going to fold. The world is not going to fold. Not this time. You know, it's pretty much less. I would go, if it happened again, I would go with the whole adage, okay, now it's time to play cleanup. It's time to, if the 2008 market crash happened again, it will be depressing, no doubt, because, I mean, I'm all for making money and all of this, but, you know, seeing people suffering, people lost their lives. You know, people dear and near to me have lost their lives because, you know, they didn't have the money that they were used to. They didn't have the resources that they were used to, and, you know, suffer from this, you know. But at the same time, I'm just going to say I would adhere to anybody that, you know, if this happened again, instead of panicking, you know, basically get your library up, get your research up, and basically when something like this happens again, you know, fall right in line and just, man, I mean, take advantage of it, because basically that's this, a lot of stuff, you know, like I tell my kids, this is really kind of like an evil game of Monopoly, you know. And it's sometimes it's fair, sometimes it's not, you know. But you want to be, you know, lock, stock, and barrel, and have leverage in this situation, or any situation. You know, you don't want to put yourself in a situation where you don't have leverage. I mean, leverage might save your life. I mean, it might, you know, put you in a position where you can kind of like develop something where your family, future, and, you know, people around, you can help others, you know, with more resources and so on and so forth than just, you know, not, you know, doing anything. So it's like, it's a situation where you want to basically take advantage of if this happens again. And then I'm be honest with you, it's still the consequences of that, it was only 8 years ago. It's still, I mean, housing is still dirt cheap. I mean, the stock market rallied to the point where, I mean, if you look at the prices of stock from 2008 to now, it'll make you depressed that you didn't put any money into it. Okay, I mean, even other things like, you know, Bitcoin, you know, stuff like that. But it's like, if you look at the here, then and now, you're talking 8 years. I mean, it's still opportunity to basically, you know, take care of business and reap the benefits of kind of like the spoils of this, you know, economic disaster, or just how just the market is, you know. It just, you could benefit still to this day from the market being down. And that goes for a lot of things, you know, and mainly real estate. But yeah, from 2008, it literally, I mean, like, everybody, it changed their life. But you know, for me, a little bit for the better, as far as, you know, I won't panic probably. I'll try not to panic if something like this ever happens again. I'll, you know, try to position myself to, you know, kind of not only